I'm coming from Germany, but I'm Indonesian, and I came to Jakarta actually this year to do charity. So I was working with anak-anak jalanan, and I was doing a workshop, giving a concert in order to give them inspiration and make them, you know, interested in music, high-quality music education, and it was great fun. I love working with children, and I hope I could inspire them, you know, to follow the path and to believe and strengthen the mind, because that's what I think music can do.
Bravo Iskandar, Iskandar, apa kabar?
Baik.
Can I
have a seat?
Yeah,
sure.
Thank you.
Why you choose violin as your musical instrument? You can play guitar, cello.
Right? I guess it was an intuitive thing. I just thought the violin is such a just enchanting instrument, you know. It's almost magical. The music for me has an hypnotic quality as well. I try to elevate people and make them see the beauty of life.
Why you choose your path outside instead in your own Indonesia?
Well, I was born in Germany, and my parents came over there to study. I've stayed in Germany because of the wonderful music education you get over there. It's really excellent. It's the best in the world, I must say. But I always come back to Indonesia because I love my country and I love the people here.
The only competition that I've heard is the Hindemith International Competition.
That's right. I won the gold medal.
Right?
Yeah, that's
right. That is so excellent.
Thank you.
How long is the preparation to win a gold medal?
You cannot really prepare to win a gold medal. I mean, it just happens or it doesn't.
Speaking about classical music, I already designed an experiment involving classical music.
Great, can't wait.
With the mind.
Yeah.
But can we do it inside?
Sure.
In the comfort of your living room?
Okay. Be my guest.
Can I choose this spot?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay.
Is this your books?
No.
No.
No. It's from my father.
Your father. But you read books?
Yes, I do.
Oh, what kind?
Mostly philosophical.
Philosophical?
Yes.
Okay. As promised before outside, I also phone with a classical composer.
Yes.
I also read books, mostly mystery and psychology books. I bring one of my favorite books with me. Written here. This is one of the favorite books, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Have you read the books?
No, I haven't.
Have you seen the movie?
Yes, I have.
Excellent. And also, this is few of my favorite composers, right? If you're at home, may not be familiar with their music.
Okay.
Is it okay if you play one of Bach piece?
Sure.
For them?
Yes.
Go ahead. This is also one of my favorite Beethoven. Excellent. Get it?
I do.
Yeah, apa ini? And shocking. And this is also Amadeus Mozart. Okay. Nice. Excellent, bravo.
Thank you.
Nah, tadi adalah contoh musik yang diciptakan oleh komposer-komposer ini. Jika Izzy Iskandar mempengaruhi pendengarnya menggunakan musiknya, saya mempengaruhi Izzy menggunakan bahasa tubuh saya dan yang dilihat oleh Izzy atau visualisasinya. Now, if you influence your listener using your music, right? Let's play an experimental game.
Okay.
Right? Out of this, I'm trying to influence you one of these composers, right? I'm sure you've got one composer in mind, right?
Yes.
If I ask you to name one of these composer, the one that you...
Should I say it right now?
Yeah.
Okay, it's Amadeus Mozart.
Amadeus Mozart.
Mozart is somebody who's really close to my heart. He's a crazy person, a childlike, childish person, but at the same time, he's a genius.
Zaman sekarang, jarang sekali generasi muda yang jatuh cinta dengan classical music. Karena zaman sekarang, hampir semuanya adalah digital. Also, nowadays, not many people who read books, genuine paper weight books.
Yes.
That's why I bring this.
Harry Potter, Goblet of Fire. I love Harry Potter.
Books, I need you to open at any page. Saya minta Iskandar buka di halaman mana saja dan pilih satu karakter. Can you put the violin in here? Okay.
Okay.
And could you name the character that you choose?
I should tell you? Okay, it's Snape.
Snape.
Yeah. I chose Snape because he's the one that I remember best from Harry Potter. He has this very dark aura whenever he appears. And I think sometimes even music needs this kind of dark approach. Some fans actually call me Vampire Goy.
Yang dipilih Iskandar adalah karakter dari Harry Potter bernama Snape dan musisi namanya Amadeus. Is it possible for me to influence you subconsciously to choose Amadeus Mozart and choose Snape at the same time?
No, that was my own choice.
Yes, actually I indeed subliminally asked you to choose Amadeus Mozart and Snape. First, must be approved, right? Yours truly. Yang dipilih Iskandar adalah karakter dari Harry Potter bernama Snape dan musisi namanya Amadeus. Is it possible for me to influence you subconsciously to choose Amadeus Mozart and choose Snape at the same time?
No, that was my own choice.
Yes, actually I indeed subliminally asked you to choose Amadeus Mozart and Snape. First, must be approved, right? You have cell phone with you?
Yes.
Okay. I put, this is your envelope, right? I put it in here as a bookmark,
yeah.
Okay?
On the page on where, the okay. Where I found Snape.
Okay,
on the page. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, close the books. Saya minta Iskandar mengeluarkan handphonenya karena setiap handphone memiliki aplikasi untuk scan barcode atau QRC code. Tujuh.
Okay.
Quick scan. Inside Johann Sebastian Bach, there is a barcode.
Okay.
Could you scan this?
Okay.
What's this? Could you show the people at home? Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah.
So if you choose Bach, the barcode mm-hmm. will show Arnold.
Okay.
Okay. I put it in here. If you choose Beethoven, could you scan the barcode? Beethoven.
Tom Cruise.
Could you show people at home? So this is the barcode for Tom Cruise, right? If you choose Beethoven, inside will be Tom Cruise.
Yes.
Right. This is inside Chopin.
That's
Robert Downey Jr. Okay. Now, if you choose inside, we'll just scan the. And it's going to be. It's going to be.
Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp, yes, Pirates of Caribbean. Saya tidak meminta Iskandar untuk mengingat itu semua. Saya hanya menunjukkan bahwa semua amplop yang dipilih berisi figur yang berbeda-beda. If you choose Hayden, you've got, lo and behold, yours truly. Yes, that's me. Sweet people at home, that's me in Hayden. But you choose Amadeus Mozart. Yeah. Where is the book? Okay, yeah. This is the books, right? Yeah. And from the Harry Potter books, you choose a character named Snape, right?
Yep.
And from those envelopes, you choose Amadeus Mozart, right? Let's scan inside this envelope. Could you take your cell phone again? Yes. Yeah, let's scan this.
Ooh.
It is Snape.
Yeah.
Shoot people at home. It is Snape inside the envelope that you choose.
Wow, how did you do that?
Bagaimana saya dapat membuat Iskandar memilih Amadeus? Di awal, saat saya berbicara, saya melakukan gerakan tangan ke arah rak buku yang secara tidak langsung membuat Iskandar melihat sebuah gelas yang bertuliskan Amadeus. Lalu, bagaimana saya dapat membuat Iskandar memilih Snape? Kalau Anda perhatikan di sini, amplop yang bertuliskan Amadeus juga memiliki pesan tersembunyi. Jika ditangkap oleh mata manusia, akan menjadi pesan terbalik yang terbaca Snape.
Thank you for playing with me.
Thank you.
Kind
of. Oh, great. No, I think it was great. I think, I didn't expect to actually, you know, be tricked by Romy, because I tried to be really careful and check all the details whether I can find a trick, but no, it's really stunning and wow, good job, Romy.
Berarti kamu orang yang paling sial di muka bumi. Kalau tadi yang dipilih ini oleh 3 orang dan yang dimakan ini